Love to travel to small towns around Northeast Wisconsin and find things that really make them unique.
It's our favorite thing to do, and you might not know it, but one of the very top art academies in the entire state is located in Denmark. But that's only part of the story. The real story is what it took to get this place up and running.
From the outside looking in, not much has changed with the Denmark feed mill since it was built in 1909. It's the inside which has been transformed into a prestigious academy of art, but with homage paid and relics restored from its former life.
It's a lot of fun, and we make sure we're trying to keep as much as we can, and it'd be fun to, you know, power them up one day and maybe just do a little demonstration with them.
The facility is festooned with a variety of old-school ads and new student art, but the process of getting to where it is today actually starts with the first trip to the basement of the abandoned mill.
I stepped off the bottom stairs, and I thought what was a concrete floor was brown, just scattered and moved.
Rats. Hundreds and hundreds of rats had taken up shelter and were thriving on leftover grain.
They were climbing over the floor joists, my shoulders, and it's like, yeah, I don't know about this, but.
For lack of a better word, a fair share of heebie-jeebies were going around.
Oh, I had a lot of heebie-jeebies. We were raising five kids next door, and I envisioned the Pied Piper, you know, carrying my children away.
But a war against the rodents was declared victorious, and a vision cast among 100-year-old beams and timbers began to take shape.
We're trying to carry through with keeping a lot of the aspects of the mill and yet making it a creative spot for artists.
The new residents, flourishing artists who relish the character of their surroundings.
It's just, when you come here, it's just, you just get so motivated. You're surrounded by other artists in the same boat with you, and teachers here are just outstanding. It's a great atmosphere.
The curriculum, demanding and traditional.
The old masters have always been an inspiration for me. And here I can kind of come and work on those skills under close instruction and critical critiques of my work.
From Renaissance reproduction to Renaissance reconstruction, a small town landmark that embraces its character and still stands tall.
This was the hub of Denmark for years. The farmers would come in, they would gather on Saturdays, their children would run around, and I love it when they come back and tell me their stories about the previous owners and spending all day Saturday here. Is it everybody's place? But it's mine.
What a historic place. Well, joining us live now, Molly Johnson, the executive director for the Academy. Wow. It's so much history goes into that.
It's a wonderful place.
I mean, does that history kind of play a part in, you know, all the art and things that are created there?
I think so. I think just the space alone, all the wood, the fantastic beams, like Faye said, it lends to so much creativity and warmth.
And that's the thing, from the outside, I love how you kept it what it looked like way back in 1909.
Yes.
But you go inside and you kept the cool aspects of the old place, but yet it's one of the most modern facilities you'll find for the students to work.
Yes, yes. Could use a little more curb appeal. We're working on it.
I think it's great the way it
okay.
is.
But that's okay.
Yep. And as for artists, as far as the space goes, really we need, you know, good lighting, just room to put out your supplies, your easel, and the model. So.
But now let's talk, too, as far as how prestigious this is.
Yes, we are one of 70 approved schools worldwide by the Art Renewal Center, which is a New York-based foundation. And that means our instructors and our curriculum are very strict, and our instructors are professional. They have to be showing, working, painting, which then lends all their experience to the students.
A lot of credibility there.
Yeah. Awesome. Now, you guys are actually having an open house this weekend. They are going to be holding that open house on Saturday, March 7th. It's taking place from 6:30 to 9 p.m. at 217th Broadway Street in Denmark. Studios will be open, and of course, there are going to be lots of tours. For even more information, just visit our website, NBC26.com, and click on this story.
Awesome. Thanks
Thank
so
you
much.
For
Good luck
Thank
this
you
weekend.
Very
really enjoyed it there. I'm not sure I'm going to be a nude model like you thought I'd be good at, but they are looking for some of those.